Hey guys, so if you saw my vlog last week, you know what we're doing. I'm attempting to do these more often and maybe weekly. I don't know, we'll see, I'm gonna try. So yeah, so bear with me. Hopefully the more I do it, the better I'll get, because that's how life works, right? So I just finished my princess calls, or technically queen, technically guardian? What would you guys call Elsa now? Is she still a queen? Is she queen of the forest? I think she's more like guardian of the forest. Let me know in the comments because yeah, I probably should know that. But I was Elsa today for Campaign One at a Time. If you watched my last vlog, you can hear more about that. And I think I'll do another video soon, maybe showing you guys some fun clips from the video calls that I've been getting to do with the kids. Every week on Fridays, I have been dressing up like a princess or queen slash character and doing video calls and singing for some really sweet kiddos. And it's been amazing, but I'm definitely exhausted today. The Elsa days are the most taxing because the songs are like intense, obviously, and not to mention she's very popular, so everyone wants to meet Elsa, and so I usually have a lot more calls on my Elsa days, and she's a lot harder for me to play. Straight up, y'all, I'm not an Elsa. I'm getting off track. But anyways, I love Elsa, but I'm an Anna. So every time I play Elsa, I feel like I have to put forth twice as much energy because it's really hard for me to not be giggly and derpy and bubbly and to be more regal and to try to channel her. It's really hard for me. So Elsa days are really exhausting. But if you're wondering why I have huge circle lenses in my eyeballs right now, it's because I want to be able to see while we do this because it's just nicer on me without my contacts, I'm blind. And I have glitter on. I had glitter on last week because I was on the Everyday Mermaid podcast coming up. They interviewed me and it's a video podcast and I wanted to be mermaidy for them. So I had glitter on my face last week. I have glitter on my face today because I was Elsa today. But anyways, I wanted to basically just make this first vlog update video, just kind of filling you guys in on what I talked about. The reason why I wanted to do these, basically, I'm working on a lot of music projects right now, all at once. And I wanna bring you guys in and give you guys more information leading up to these big music videos because I feel like it's just like a big, hey, surprise, here's the thing. And so I thought it'd be fun in the meantime to, yeah, just chat with you and let you know what I'm doing in the process as we get closer and closer to the releases. And then in the meantime, you'll know, you know, I'm not just falling asleep. I'm definitely working hard and trying to get you guys the kinds of videos that it seems like you like the best and the kind of videos that I like the best, which are the music ones. So I wanted to just tell you what I'm doing as much as I can, because some things I'm not allowed to share yet, but some things I am. And so the next video, I think, I always say this and then sometimes things get like switched up in the order of when they're released or what's edited first or what have you, but I think the next music video that you guys are gonna see here is another Show Yourself video. I'm planning to release another Frozen 2 Show Yourself cover video, but the reason is we are releasing an acoustic version, or at least I'm gonna call it, I think, the acoustic mix or something. It's basically just a remix of the existing cover, the one from our big recent music video. When we were recording the song, usually the way that my process works with my music producers is I tell them what song I want to cover. We talk on the phone quite a bit. We'll go over, sometimes if we can be in person, we will, but obviously right now that's not the case. But I'll go over styling, what I want it to sound like, I'll send references. We'll really go in together on the feel and the sound and the instruments and like all of the details of the music track, right? So from the get-go with Show Yourself, I knew what I wanted, and my goal with these covers is always to obviously I want to bring a lot of that nostalgia, and I want you guys to experience any Disney magic that can possibly be experienced, right? But I also really want to put myself into it. I want to put my own style, because I'm of the mind that, unless you're entertaining children trying to pretend to be the character, why cover something if you're gonna just try to be the same as the original? You know, like, I could never be as good as the original, and it doesn't need to exist if I'm just trying to mimic that, right? And so for me, what's most fun is to try to find ways to put my own style and my own taste into it, just my own, like, what I like to listen to, and just, you know, find ways to bring myself to it and just do a little different spin, just so it's something new and interesting for if someone's just coming across it. You know, it's something to check out that's different. And so for our track for Show Yourself, you'll notice in the beginning there's like I think it sounds kind of like an icy feel. There's like this cold, synthy vibe. I really love like synthy stuff. You'll notice that in a lot of my music is I'm very into like having that as an element, like synth pop, and just having, I like electronic sounds. So yeah, that's a thing. But yeah, you'll notice that in the beginning of the track, like you don't have that typical, or not typical, you don't have that classic nostalgic piano. And it's weird to use the word nostalgic, I know, because Frozen 2 is not a movie that's been around for very long. And yet Disney manages to do that, right? They literally make us feel nostalgic sometimes the first time we listen to something, which is amazing. For my track, that was a big change that I wanted, is obviously we brought in Halle to do the intro of the song As All Is Found. I love intros. I did it on Let It Go too. I love, like, I don't know, starting off with something unexpected. And her voice is so beautiful. And I love that it sounds like it is a lullaby, but I love how it just, the feel is so lullaby in the beginning. And then obviously it goes into Show Yourself. And in the beginning, one of my bigger goals with the music side of the track was I wanted to remove that piano, because I wanted to completely change the feel of my version so that it just was a totally new interpretation, and so that it was less compared to the original. Because, that's something that is fun for me, and I kind of heard it in my head the way that I wanted it, and my music producer, Yaris Daniel, was so kind and worked really hard with me to get it to where I, you know, heard the thing that I heard in my imagination. And so as we go to record the song, I work on the song, and he typically will do we'll call it like a scratch track, just a instrumental for me to record to that's usually just piano, and that way we can get the vocals down and recorded as quickly as possible so that there's as much time for my music producer to produce the vocals and produce the music all together. And sometimes I feel like it helps, because as much as it's nice to record to your finished track and have that feel, if you're able to give the performance to piano, which I actually love piano, so I don't mind that at all, he can really build and create a track that complements the vocals too, which I think is really cool. So he sent me a piano version. It's actually piano and guitar. I think the original was just piano and a little bit of guitar, and that's what we recorded to. And after we get vocals down, I get a bounce of the version with just the raw vocals to kind of sit with and make sure that I'm good with the takes that we've chosen. And, you know, just kind of, I always have a current bounce of the track handy as we're working on the project. And obviously we have to record the music video to something with the right timing with the takes that are the ones that we're gonna use in the final music video, right? So when we were recording, we actually record the video just to that piano rough bounce. And then obviously when you guys see the video, it's got the final track in there. As we were working on this song, I got really attached to the piano. And it's funny because that was the one thing that I was really excited to remove from my track, or our track, I should say. But what was funny is the more I listened to the piano bounce or the acoustic bounce or whatever, before I had the final, I noticed that, and I've said this a lot with this project, but I cried a lot making this video. This was a really emotional project. And that's actually the comment that I've been getting the most on that video. It's a comment I get on a lot of videos. I think it's a huge compliment, but I don't want to make people cry. But the comment that I get a lot is that people say they're crying, or that it really, you know, touched them and brought a tear to their eye, because it's just like all the kids, you know, it's just a very emotional scene in the movie, not only, but an emotional video that we made with the sweet kids that were in our video too. So, oh my gosh, bring it back, Tracy. I'm losing my train of thought. But when I was listening to the piano track, and I listen a lot in the car, there's a lot of decision making going on while I'm driving long distances. My costumer is like 3 to 4 hours away from me, and so there are long drives back and forth while working on costuming and all sorts of stuff. And I actually really like that, because, I mean, obviously it's, you know, it'd be nicer if we were closer together, but it's also nice to have that time to sit in the car and really kind of work here and not be distracted by anything else. You know, I'm stuck in my car, so I have to focus. And so while I was doing these drives back and forth to see Cassie, our amazing costumer, I was just crying. Like, every time I listened to the song, I was tearing up. And it's not my voice, it's not me, it's, you know, it's just the emotions that were brought up by the music. And when I got our track, like our finished track, back from Joris, I was obsessed with it. I still, to this day, I love it so much, and I'm crazy happy with it. But it brought different emotions out in me, and I noticed that, and I don't know if it's just me, or if it was just certain days I felt a little more emotional than others, but I really do feel like it was a music thing. With our finished track, I felt excited and energized, and like, you know, there's like adventure vibes because it gets really big. And obviously it's emotional too, but it's a different feel than the acoustic track that we recorded to. And so I decided back then that if possible, I really wanted to release two versions of our cover. So it's the same vocal performance. It's not like it's a actual acoustic live performance or anything like that. That would be cool, but this is the same performance, but the music is totally different. And so I decided back then that I wanted to give you guys two different versions of the song, if you'd like. Because I think there's a lot of people out there who prefer things to sound more like stripped down and raw. And so for those people, I'm hoping that they enjoy it. And there's a lot of people out there, I think like me, who just like to hear the different versions of things and appreciate both for different reasons. And so I just figured it was really special, and why the heck not if we can, and it's not that difficult to do. You know, cause really I just asked Joris, I was like, hey, can you like throw the completed vocals back onto our scratch track? And yeah, everything's the same basically, except the vocals are just more like fancy produced. Yours uses all the pretty things to make them sound as good as possible. But yeah, I was just really excited to do that. So we finally have it. I just got it the other day. I'm really excited. So I'm gonna be releasing that. It'll be on iTunes and all the music stores and all that jazz. And then I just figured, if I'm gonna release essentially a new single, to me it's kind of like half of a whole, but you know, if I'm gonna release new music, the best way to get the word out and the best way to share it with people is here, because this is my place, you know? Like, oddly enough, I feel like my music is much more heard on YouTube than even Spotify and all those places. And so I thought we should make a little music video. I thought it'd be really fun. And now we have the added challenge of making a music video in quarantine, which is kind of a fun challenge, honestly. It's not a bad thing. Oh, and I was gonna mention, for any of you guys that have been with me for a long time, like for those of you that have been around since, if you remember my single Stay With You, if you remember Lovebird, a lot of the music that I released with my friend Adam Gubman years and years ago, my original songs, what we would do is we would release our version, we would release our song. There we go. We'd release our song, and then we would typically, Adam would create an acoustic mix, like a version that was different, that usually had a lot less instrumentation, and it's more of focusing on the vocals and just simpler. But if you were with me way back then, you remember, for the people that bought the single, and I'm trying to remember if they sent me, I think they sent screen caps. We had like a special email where people would show me like proof that they bought the song. And if they bought the song, we would send them the acoustic mix for free. And that was like a special thing we did way back in the day. Nowadays, I feel like it's easier just to release. And then if people don't want to buy it, they can listen on Spotify, hopefully, and still, you know, listen here for free. There's no charge to listen on YouTube. So anyways, I feel like it's a nice little nod back to my past when I was first releasing music. But yeah, so I'm excited. That's the thing that I'm working on right now first, that's probably the most current that you will probably see first. So stay tuned for that. I'm really excited to share it with you. And the thing that I think is gonna be really special about this particular mix and also video is I get to share with you guys, it's more an emphasis on the vocals and my amazing friends that I worked with, because when you remove all of these layers and elements and all of this crazy, awesome, big instrumentation, which we love, you're left with mainly just the vocals. And for me, that can be a little scary because I'm a production girl. But what I really love about the acoustic version is you get to hear my friends Amy and Brandon, who did the background vocals. You get to hear them, to me, so much better. You can like really focus on just all of these voices coming together. And obviously Hallie sounds amazing, and you're gonna be able to hear her even better and more clearly in this version. And my goal is to have all of us on camera showing when we're all singing. And it's gonna be hard because like I sang background vocals too. We all sang, Hallie did too. We all did like different parts and stuff. Amy and Brandon did the brunt of the background vocals. It's primarily them, but me and Hallie did too, so we're not gonna be able to sing all of our parts at the same time. Like, me and Hallie will stick to our main roles of the Elsa vocal and the Aduna vocal. You guys are gonna get to see Amy and Brandon singing on camera to their parts, and I think that's so cool. I'm so excited for you to see them because it's, to me, it's kind of like peeling back the curtain a little bit. And it's not like it's a live recording session or anything like that, but we're so rushed with the project. I wish we had been able to film better when we recorded. We recorded in this room here in my little office, because sometimes that's what you gotta do to get stuff done. It's just gonna be a nice visual representation of who's singing where and what's actually happening vocally in the track for you guys to visually see, because I think it just makes it kind of extra special and hopefully helps everyone to really appreciate them even more. Because I think when you watch a big video like that, you don't realize all of the people sometimes and all of the other amazing influences that have been given to the project. And so for me, this is a way to get to share my amazing friends and their talent with you even more, and I'm really excited. So if you guys have any suggestions for how you want to see the video visually represented, let me know in the comments, because I want to know what you guys want to see. This video is primarily about the audio. It's just to share it with you. There's not going to be any sort of like cosplay or anything in this one. It's just going to be us as ourselves. We'll probably Disney bound if we can. I'll find something sparkly maybe to wear. I don't know. But I'm thinking that we're all going to film on a black backdrop, and we'll have Brandon, hopefully, if he's free, work some editing magic. If not, one of my other amazing friends will work some editing magic and put us all in the same video. And I'd love to have us in the same space in the video rather than boxes. There's a lot of amazing people on YouTube here that do like the different boxes where they sing all different parts, and like that's amazing and I love it, but it's not really my style, you know, it's not me. So I'm trying to think of some fun out of the box ideas to do something that is like that, where you can see all of us, but maybe not a grid, maybe something else. So anyways, we're workshopping it. We're gonna see what we can make happen. But yeah, I'm really excited. So stay tuned for that. I did wanna let you guys know, this is already getting long because I talk a lot. I'll come back on probably next week and tell you more about the other projects that I'm working on. And those ones are still under wraps a lot right now anyways. There's not a lot that I can share. One is a branded project and it has a sponsor, which is amazing and so exciting. And so there's a lot of approvals and stuff that need to happen, and I'm not gonna share until I'm able to with that one, but I'm real excited about it. And by the way, you guys, I wanted to tell you too, anytime I do anything that's sponsored, it means so much to me when you show it love and when you're really excited and open to that, because it's really hard for me to do what I do. It's expensive and, you know, crazy intense to do the big projects. So when we have a sponsor, that is like, it's a crazy blessing because they allow me to do what I do, to do more of it, and to bring you guys more content. So I really appreciate when you guys are so warm and welcoming to the sponsors that I work with and stuff. And obviously I'm only working with sponsors that I really like and people that I want to share with you and brands and, you know, all that sort of stuff. So but that one's coming up, and that one's going to be more of an actual music video, you know, like actual music video. And then the other one I'm working on is also still very secret because it's very much in the early stages, but I'm really excited about it. And that one's a cosplay music video, and it's an original song. So the branded one's a cover, and the other one's an original song. I just wrote it the other day because I don't know, I was trying to think of a song to cover for this project, and I was like, oh, I'm just gonna write something. That's more fun for me. So lots of things are happening. My life is very different, just like all of us. We're all living very different lives, I think, than we thought we would be at this point of 2020. I thought by now I would either be filming or be finished filming the biggest music video I've been working towards for the past 3 years. It's related to my album, but it has to be on hold because it's location and I can't shoot on location right now. So a lot of the things that I thought I would be sharing with you are on hold right now, but I'm really excited that at least there's a lot of other really fun stuff that I can do literally from here in my house that I can share with you, and it's inspired me to write new music and really like think out of the box and try to be extra, extra creative and see like what the heck I can do. Because sometimes I feel like if you put limitations on something, you have to be extra creative, you know? And so it kind of forces you to work that muscle. And so it's not a bad thing, but it's hard to wait. It's hard to wait for the things I've been wanting for a long time, but I can do it. And I know you can do it too. I hope you guys are doing okay this week. I've been sick. 99% sure it's not COVID related, but I got an infection last week and I've been on antibiotics. I'm like on my third round of antibiotics and I'm finally a little bit better, but I'm still kind of sick. So pray for me if you think about it. It's very mild. It's not a big deal, but yeah, I'm definitely hoping to get more energy and more health back next week. I'm gonna rest all this weekend, but yeah, I'm really excited about all the things and I'm excited to share them with you guys. So I love you. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you on the next one.